Everybody just bouncing, feel the beat of the drums. It's a happy welcome song, so make sure you smile. Now, traveling arms from low to high.
I'm so excited on the top.
And burst. Hold your heart.
Feel the joy down in my heart.
Now, swing your arms like you're marching.
That is why I'm singing and dancing.
Reach to the audience.
You are welcome. We love you.
Hold your heart. Reach to the audience again.
You are welcome.
And we do the whole thing again.
Yes, I am. So
traveling arms. And burst. Hold your heart. Swing your marching arms. Reach both hands. Do that one more time. Now a new soloist comes forward. And turn your arms. Burst. Hold your heart. Swing your marching style arms. Reach to the audience. Now bring forward a new soloist. Here we go. Turn. Burst. Reach your hands to your heart. Swing your marching hands. Reach to the audience. Hands to your heart. Again, reach. Now we step, clap, and celebrate a little bit. Now clap on every beat. Reach to the audience. Hands to your heart. Do that again. And one more time, slower this time. You are welcome to your heart. And everybody wave to the audience. Y'all, welcome, friend.
Welcome once again to another virtual Sunday school brought to you via YouTube and Facebook. My name is Shanae Banton, and I am a member of the CYM and a junior Sunday school teacher at the Anglican Church of the Epiphany, Prince Charles Drive, where Kanan Badu is the rector. This week's lesson will be about harvest. But before we get started, we will begin our Sunday school with our choruses and our prayer. Tanisha Banton will say the prayer for us today.
Jesus loves the little children of the world.
Jesus.
like to think about the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just want to lift my hands and say that I love him. I just want to lift my heart in praise. And I want to be faithful. I want to be faithful. I want to remember everything that the Lord has done. I want to be faithful. I want to be grateful. I want to be, I want to be, I want to be. I like to think about the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just want to lift my hands and say that I love him. I just want to lift my heart in praise. And I want to be faithful. I want to be grateful. I want to remember everything that the Lord has done. I want to be faithful. I want to be grateful. I want to be, I want to be, I want to be faithful. I want to be grateful. I want to remember everything that the Lord has done. I want to be faithful. I want to be grateful. I want to be, 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 I want to be.
Please bow your heads and close your eyes. Dear God, thank you for waking us up. Thank you for the food, the clothes. Thank you for everything, God. We pray that you heal us for our blessings. In your holy name we pray, amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Tanisha, for that wonderful prayer. Now, boys and girls, do you remember what we spoke about last week? Last week's Sunday was Remembrance Day. Can you remember two things we learned about Remembrance Day? You have 4 minutes to have your parents find the church's chat or post to Mr. Montez Williams the two things you can remember about Remembrance Day. Mr. Montez's number is 376-8601. I'll say it again, 376-8601. Okay, boys and girls, I'm going to tell you the answers. If you send any two of the answers, we will award you, but the postings would have to be 3 minutes ago and not when I said them. Here we go. We learned about the poppy being a real flower. The poppy was found among the grave sites of the persons that died. And we also learned that thousands of people died in World War I for us. Okay, boys and girls, let's go over the story of harvest. An old farmer sat on the steps of his small shack chewing on a piece of straw. He was approached by a passing stranger who was looking for a cool drink of water. Wishing to start a conversation with the farmer, the stranger asked, "How is your cotton crop coming this year?" "I ain't got none," replied the farmer. "Didn't you plant any?" asked the stranger. "Nope," said the farmer. "I was afraid the boll weevils would get it." "Well," asked the stranger, "how is your corn?" "Didn't plant any corn either," replied the man. "I was afraid there wasn't going to be any rain." "If you didn't plant any cotton or corn, what did you plant?" asked the man. "Nothing," said the farmer. "I just played it safe." "Well, I guess if you didn't plant anything, it makes the harvest a lot easier, doesn't it?" In our Bible reading today, Jesus set out people to bring in the harvest. The harvest Jesus was talking about was not cotton, fruits, or vegetables. He was sending out workers to bring people into the kingdom of God. He said that there were many souls who were ready to be harvested, but there were not enough workers. One reason it was hard to find workers was that it was very difficult to work. Jesus warned that the workers in his kingdom would often be treated very unkindly. Jesus is still looking for people to work with him today to bring into his kingdom. That is what the church is supposed to do. It won't always be easy. In fact, it will be really hard. Okay, boys and girls, let's watch our video about harvesting crops.
This is fun, Big Bear. Oh, yes, I'm hoping this will be our best harvest yet.
I love harvest time, especially the big party afterwards.
Mmm, harvest time is tasty too.
Plenty of time for that later, Raggles. We've still got lots more to pick.
Aww.
Yes, come on, everyone. Keep up the good work.
Bluebird, shouldn't you be helping with the harvest today?
Help? Me? Oh, yes, of course. They'll never manage without me. See you later, Oakley. You missed one. Oop, and another.
Well done, everyone. We've finished the harvest.
Hooray!
Oh, no. Look at these. Oh, some of my fruit and vegetables have been damaged by the frost. What are we going to do with them all? Oh, what a waste.
Don't worry, Big Bear. Maybe some of them are okay. Not all of them are ruined. There is some good fruit and vegetables amongst this lot. Somewhere.
These plums taste good.
Mr. and Mrs. Mordy the Dormice. What are they doing? You've got to come and see this. The Mordys have given me a great idea. Well?
I don't get it.
We're going to make sofas?
No, not quite. But if the Mordys can think of other uses for the fruit and vegetables, then I'm sure we can think of ways to use them too.
But they're so squishy.
Yes, but maybe that's not such a bad thing.
Hey?
Come on, Big Bear. Help me carry lots of the squished fruit to the playhouse and I'll show you.
Okay, Rosie.
Try to use as much of the fruit and vegetables as you can. I'm sure we can make this harvest a success.
Ready, Rosie?
Great! Let's go!
I know what I can do with these.
What are you going to do with all those, Will?
You'll see.
Oh, well. Looks like I'll have to be chief taster all on my own.
Yum!
What are you doing? Oh, now they're even more squashed.
Ah, but squashed fruit makes delicious juice. Here, have a taste.
Mmm, this is the best juice ever. Well done, Rosie.
See? All that fruit wasn't wasted after all. We just needed to use it in a different way.
La 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 loo, loo, loo. Oh, I've seen potato prints before, loads of times.
Not like this.
What are you doing?
You'll see.
Wow, oh, that's cool.
Oh, it'll soon be time for our harvest party, Big Bear.
Yes.
What's wrong? Aren't you excited?
Well, I think it's great that you managed to use some of the fruit, Rosie, but I still feel bad about the rest of it. I hate waste.
I rolled the pastry out just like you asked, Holly, but... I think I'm ready for you to do your stuff now.
Coming!
Hold it tighter, Holly. Left a bit, right a bit.
Well, my house and garden look great, Holly. How did you do it?
With your potatoes, of course.
Potatoes?
Welcome to your special harvest party, Big Bear.
But what about the rest of the vegetables? Where have they all gone?
They're here! In this big pie.
Really?
Yep. Holly helped me make it.
See, Big Bear? The fruit and vegetables didn't look perfect, but they were still good enough to eat. Go on, have a taste.
Well?
Oh, yummy! It's the best vegetable pie I've ever tasted. Let the party begin!
Hooray!
But where's Raggles? We can't have a harvest party without him.
Don't worry, Rosie. We'll find him.
Look, a plum stone. Raggles was eating plums earlier.
An apple core.
I found a half-eaten carrot, too.
They must be clues. Quick, let's follow them. Look at the mess you've made.
Whoops, sorry. I got a bit carried away. Sorry about the mess, Big Bear.
That's okay, Raggles. You've reminded me that rubbish can be useful too.
Rubbish? How?
Easy. If I save these seeds, pips and stones, and plant them, we'll have an even bigger harvest next year.
Wow, that's clever.
The rest of the waste will turn into new soil called compost to feed the new plants.
So nothing is wasted from this harvest after all, Big Bear?
Not a thing. And now the next harvest will be even better.
Hooray!
Time to celebrate.
All we need is some music. Whoops, that's not my whistle. What are you doing in there, Ed? Whoa! It works!
Oh, this is the best harvest party ever! Thanks, Rosie!
So we didn't waste anything, Oakley. Raggles even played a carrot whistle, didn't you, Raggles?
It sounds fun, Rosie.
Raggles, you can't be hungry. Aren't you full?
Almost done. Close your eyes.
Ooh.
Ta-da!
A necklace made from melon seeds. Oh, Raggles, I love it. Thank you. Surely you're not going to eat that too.
Don't be silly, Rosie. This one's special. I've been saving it.
What for, Raggles?
It'll make a great bongo drum.
I hope you remember something from that video for review next week, Sunday. Your memory verse for this week is taken from Luke chapter 10, verse 2. The harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. asked the Lord of the harvest, therefore, to send out workers into his harvest field. I am going to read the memory verse slowly two more times so that your parents or bigger sibling can help you write it down. The harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. Ask the Lord of the harvest, therefore, to send out workers into his harvest field. One more time. The harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. Ask the Lord of the harvest, therefore, to send out workers into his field. Well, boys and girls, we have come to an end. Please tell others about our Sunday school and invite them to come along next week. Now, we will sing happy birthday to all of those people in our church who are celebrating birthdays this week. You guys have a wonderful birthday week. I hope I get a piece of birthday cake. Now quiet yourselves and become very still as we listen to our closing song, which is a prayer.